I think what people might be surprised to know is that I lie viciously during questionnaires. I was about to say it's my son laughing, but I have to admit, after the day I've had, I think my favorite sound is silence. I'm not good with those high-pitched scratches or screeching like forks on plates, fingernails on blackboards, kids' voices. I'm actually still waiting to do my best work. However, preference, my best work would be silence. Reality, the work I do, which is not necessarily my best work, is more often than not in noise. There is a poem by Edward Thomas called Adlestrop, and there is a reading of that poem by Richard Burton, and I could listen to that reading of Adlestrop by Richard Burton until Judgment Day. Possibly the book that has been the greatest influence on me is a book called Rich by Melvyn Bragg. It's a biography of Richard Burton. And the reason it was important to me is because it made me aware or made me realize that a career in acting was possible. What I like most about storytelling is ideally to lose myself or to forget myself, to be so engrossed in something where I'm so moved. I go on a journey and I'm totally engrossed and I forget everything. And you're absolutely present in the story's moment and you forget everything else. What do I dislike most in storytelling? I suppose what I dislike most is happy coincidences when you kind of go, oh, that worked out well. Or sensationalism, where something is done to kind of shock for the sake of it without really having earned it. If I had to pick a plot character or setting, I think it would be plot, because if there's a good plot, I'll follow it. I mean, sometimes good characters come from good plot, and a good setting is just, you know, a bonus. But to me, plot is always the most important thing, or certainly the most interesting. If I had my dream choice of who would narrate my life, it would be Richard Burton. For many reasons, not least the very sound of his voice. The short answer is no, I don't like the sound of my own voice because when I hear it, I tend to fixate on all the things I don't like about it. So the answer is no. The bulk of my creation or writing or storytelling is for my four-year-old son. And during these lockdown days, there's been a lot of that where we create worlds with little figures, men, animals, and fill them with our stories. Or I kind of lead him in the storytelling. Although he's getting pretty inventive these days. So yes, the bulk of my creation goes to him. I suppose, I don't suppose, I know, my partner's approbation is the person I seek out most. And if I impress her, then I'm happy. I suppose my definition of success is if I feel I've done it well, I've succeeded. However, I would like to also point out I've never experienced that. So I'm still searching for that definition of success. I suppose my greatest achievement is my son, although there's plenty of time to ruin that. One great achievement that I find is when I've played an American and Americans think I was American. That to me is the highest form of praise. Perfect day is usually in nature with a family, preferably the mountains, with a body of water like a lake. And if you throw in a horse, not literally, but if I get to ride one, then it really is a perfect day. My guilty pleasure is a very obvious one, late night chocolate, really. It's a bad one. It needs to stop. It's slightly out of control. I think what people might be surprised to know is that I lie viciously during questionnaires.